staff and workers and employees of the registration authority. I'd like to express our thanks to PIDS for inviting us to speak before you today and share with you our insights on the presentations earlier made, and share as well our experiences in the agency in the course of our implementation of the computerization project, which is, I think, the most significant project that we have undertaken so far. All right. As directed in the email of Dr. Sheila, I will state briefly our reaction to the presentations made earlier. And I'd like to commend the exhaustive analysis made by Dr. Lianco on the condition of our regulation system in the Philippine context. And we share in his proposed solutions to be at par with the other countries. I have just been, I've just attended a conference in Istanbul 2 weeks ago, and the thrust really worldwide now is for the promotion of SMEs. And one basic consideration that I noticed in that conference was that while different countries may have different scenarios or environments, what is important is that we adjust to our own respective environment and try to achieve the objectives, no, the best way we can. I'd also like to stress the statement made by Chairman Hines in that public consultation is very important, especially in government. Relating that to our experience, when we embarked on our computerization project, our administrator saw it proper to engage directly our stakeholders, as a result of which our stakeholders formed an association. So this is an association of associations, which we call the TAPS, or the Organization of Property Stakeholders. And through this, we're able to communicate directly with our stakeholders, whereas before, we communicate with them through their complaints, through media, through white papers, and like that. But with the institution of this organization, we were able to come up with regulations and new services that directly came from the ideas of these stakeholders, namely the banks, developers, brokers, financial institutions, the ordinary tao. So it's very important that government agencies be transparent and deal directly, as indirectly talaga, with the public and the stakeholders. And also, it's very important to reiterate what he said, that quoting Nelson Mandela, if I'm not mistaken, he said that it may appear impossible at first, but similar to our experience when we embarked on the project, it seemed impossible just even to take off in working on the project, but we persisted and we are now almost complete. Now, with regard to Mr. Gary Domingo, we laud the efforts being undertaken by the global government of Quezon City in promoting the ease of doing business. Because for those who were not in the know, Quezon City was the city chosen by the World Bank in the ease of doing business under the supervision of the National Competitiveness Council. In that, all the indicators being monitored are based on the performance of Quezon City. So I can only commiserate with the mayor and the rest of the men and women of the local government in Quezon City when they face World Bank and IFC and all other agencies, especially when they're being criticized they being the microcosm of the entire country. So, but I'd like to share that they are doing the best that they can. As in fact, we are engaged in two indicators, the one registering property and obtaining construction permit. Now, for Mr. Borsi, he stressed the need for full support in terms of funding projects, and which I agree, because without the support, all of these would only be ideas. Okay, we have so many ideas, but if we do not give government the support that it needs in terms of funding and the proper framework, we will not be able to achieve the objective. And also, I'd like to emphasize on his statement that we are number one in terms of providing seafarers in the country. And I thought that it's very important with that information, but the more we need to protect, you know, our seafarers because of this information. Now, to relate the experience of the LRA, okay, I brought the PowerPoint presentation which I used during our summit. I'll just run through this so that forward. Anyway, to give you an idea, before I proceed, I'd like to give you an idea of what LRA is all about. Okay. We were established in 1903, no? When the Americans came, they introduced the torrent system of registration. So we have been in existence for more than 100 years. We computerized. The contract actually was entered to in the year 2000. So from 1903 to 2000, you can just imagine the magnitude of documents that our office has been processing all throughout those years. Maraming na ako nasunog because of the war. So medyo nabawasan pa yon. And basically our mandate is to be the guardian of the torrent system to help ensure the efficient execution of the laws relating to registration of lands, which includes personal properties, and geared towards the massive and accelerated land reform and social justice performance of the government, and also to implement all orders, decisions, and decrees promulgated relative to the registration of lands and issue all needful rules and regulations therefore. Now, what were the challenges that we faced, no? Before we embark on the computerization project. Okay. We had disorganized records management, defective survey plans, existence of fake titles, lack of uniform procedures in the registries, slow processing of registration, transactions, slow response to queries, and inefficient reporting system. So, as I've said, we embarked on a computerization project which we call the Land Titling Computerization Project, or the LTCP. And through this, okay, this is an IT-based modernization project. It was undertaken under the BOT law. I think one of the major IT projects in the country now. The government did not spend a single centavo for this because it is a variant of the BOT or the BOO, where the project proponent built the entire project, and they would be owning the system during the concession period, and they will be operating it also during the concession period, but. The government still owns the data and the database to be generated. Okay. So basically, the project involves the computerization not only of the documents but also the processes of the LRA. And presently, we have 154 registries live, meaning it is now already using the system designed by a project proponent called the Filaris, or the Philippine Land Registration System. And we are interconnected nationwide, meaning we can monitor from the central office each transaction entered in all live registries anywhere in the country. Okay, so for those who are practitioners of or in the brokerage, in the brokerage system, real property, you can monitor the progress of the transaction in the registry by using our LOTS, or the LRA online tracking system. Just log on to our website and you'll be able to monitor at what stage of the process the transaction is at the moment, almost real time. Now, in the course of the construction of the project, we were able to realize or discover new services. But these new services was actually borne out by the clamor of our stakeholders. So as I've said earlier, many of the new services that we were able to develop was born out of the ideas of the stakeholders. One of which, the A2A or the anywhere-to-anywhere service, before, during the manual system of registration, if you want to obtain a certified true copy of a title, for example, in Cebu, you have to go to the Cebu Register of Deeds. You have to travel all the way to Cebu, lodge your request, and then they will issue a certified true copy manually. To the A2A, you need not go to Cebu. If you're based in Manila or in Quezon City, you can simply go to the Register of Deeds nearest you and file a request for the certified true copy of that title in Cebu. Okay, and vice versa. Okay. Okay, so we have other services developed, like the parcel verification. You are now able to see the polygon, no, of the title that you have based on the technical description. Now, what's the significance of this? If your title has some errors, then you'll be able to see the polygon if it's open or if it's closed. So that helps basically the financial institutions, the banks, in conducting due diligence in case titles are presented to them for as collaterals, no, when obtaining loans. We also engaged in linking with our agencies like the BIR. So now it's now operational, the LRA-BIR linkage. If you transfer a title, transfer ownership, one of the requirements is the CAR, or the Certificate Authorizing Registration, that you obtain from the BIR. Before, there are many cases of anomalies and frauds. Sometimes there's underpayment, sometimes they use fake cars. But through this engagement with BIR, we are now able to validate, you know, the authenticity of the CAR electronically, because the information is sent electronically from the BIR to the Register of Deeds concerned by shooting the form given to the taxpayer to the barcode system. What are the challenges that we face, you know, after embarking on this computerization project? We realized that computerization, while very important, it is not the cure for everything. There are still many challenges that we face. For example, there is the law on reconstitution. While we have now embarked on the e-titling, whereby the original copy of the title previously stored in the vault of the Register of Deeds these are now digitalized, no? So wala nang physical owner's duplicate kapag ka i-title ng title mo. Ang what is now the physical paper is the owner's duplicate presented to the owner. But the thing is, there are still many manually issued titles in the vaults of our registries. And these titles are at the risk of being lost, destroyed due to man-made or natural calamities. And if that happens, the remedy under the law is to file a petition for reconstitution, which aside from being too cumbersome, is expensive because you have to hire a lawyer, you have to pay, you know, the lawyer every time you go to court. When we can already more or less process the reconstitution without going to court. But we are constrained from doing so, even if we have the capability to do so, because there is a law. So there is a need for legal reforms. Another example is the title that is lost is the owner's duplicate, the one in your possession. We can easily replace that because we have now a record in the database. But the law existing now provides that for you to be able to have a new owner's duplicate issued, you have to file a petition in court. So again, it's too cumbersome and expensive for the landowner. So again, we need legal reform, allowing us to, or simply the public, to go by way of administrative issuance of new owner's duplicate. And then there is also the correction of simple errors on the title. All of these need to go to court. Wala kami magawa, kahit sabi namin, simple lang yan, letter A, na dapat yan, B, letter Y, naging Juana. Simple lang yan, kasi may mga ebidensya naman siya, may deed of sale, okay? But, you know, yun ang batas, so wala kami magawa. So we need to have these reforms undertaken. Now, relating this now to the subject matter, it's quite clear that on hindsight, yes, it would have been very ideal na noon pa, sana meron na tayong itong effective regulation system so that all the laws or regulations passed by all the agencies are issued in conjunction or in relation to the other agencies. Kasi hindi naman tayo an island by itself, no? One way or another, interconnected tayo, lahat ng issuances ng bawat agency affects the other, especially the public. But that is not the case. But it's not too late. Precisely, as far as LRA is concerned, we embarked on this major project, and somehow we are able to address the major or majority of the challenges that we were facing before, and we are not stopping, no, from embarking on new services that will help the public. And as I've said, it's very important for us to engage directly with the stakeholders because they are, after all, primarily the ultimate client. No? We are here to serve the public. So whatever they say, we should be able to hear directly and understand clearly so that we would be able to come up with the proper rule or regulation that is truly responsive to their needs. So I'd like to reiterate the recommendation for the development of a strong regulatory management system for the country. But we are not short of studies. So I think it's time to act so that we can achieve all these recommendations and plans for a good regulatory practice in the hope of promoting and sustaining growth in the country. In other words, it's time to walk the talk. Okay? Let's stop pointing let's do what we need to do in our own respective fields and offices, because that's the only way by which we can achieve what we are discussing here today. So with that, I'd like to thank the IDS, and good afternoon to you.